OpenAI's new feature, Canvas, is huge. I am obsessed with this. Listen, it's not getting a ton of publicity, but it's actually going to change how you work. And this is one of my very few jaw-dropping things that I've seen, because this is really changing how everybody uses ChatGPT. Now, of course, you've seen really cool video generation, song generation, all that kind of stuff. That's awesome. But does it really change how you work every day? Not really. This will. But remember, OpenAI has not exactly slowed down, right? They've been coming out with cool new features, one of the biggest being O1, which is a huge reasoning model. That's a big step on the path to AGI, or artificial general intelligence, and that's huge. They also have faster voice now, so it makes it feel like you're having a conversation. Stuff around vision, coding, etc. But again, I'm obsessed with Canvas, because it feels like I now have an actual writing assistant, but not like a normal writing assistant, like a writing assistant that I've like rubbed Aladdin's lamp and it's come out in this purple, big smoky poof, and it's granted me 3 wishes. That's how obsessed I am with this. So it is a little like Claude's artifacts. If you've seen Anthropic Claude, they have artifacts. It looks a little like this, but again, more useful, more practical, because it feels like a writing assistant. And I know it sounds like, oh, boring. Watch this. I'm going to show you. Let's dive into a demo. Okay, so here we are. We're going to look at now what the Canvas feature is in ChatGPT. So first of all, you're going to want to toggle over to Canvas. By the way, you have to have a paid subscription. Guys, get a paid subscription to ChatGPT. It's the most powerful technology in the human history. $20 a month. You're fine. I know it's expensive, but you're fine. So toggle on to Canvas. And now watch this. Write a blog about AI and robotics, right? Doesn't really matter. Point being, you're going to see right away that what this is going to do, it sort of looks like Claude artifacts if you've used that. Over here, it's saying, sure, that's what I'm doing. And over here, it's actually writing the thing. Now, you already know it's probably going to be good and all that kind of stuff. So it's like, here's how I wrote it, blah, blah, blah. But here's the amazing thing. In the past, you could only say, okay, could you make this a little more like this, or make this a little more like this? But let's say you love a lot of it, but then part of it you don't really love. So, well, let's sort of go down here and sort of say ethical considerations, right? So we may just like want to highlight that and then see how it says, ask ChatGPT. Well, what do you want to do? Make this more dramatic, right? Something like that. And then watch what it's going to do. It's just going to change this sentence. And then, of course, it has to like lead in with the less with the following sentences to make sure it makes sense. But it's like significant challenges. One major concern is a profound impact. It's more dramatic. So instead of having all this in line saying, can you change it like this and being vague, you can be specific. That's why it feels like a writing assistant. So that to me is already amazing. But then it has all these other like little cool features, right? So you can add emojis. I don't know why we'd want to do that. You can add a final polish, which just means it goes through and sort of like cleans it up. Get back to that in a second. Reading level. I won't do this, but like you can kind of make it up to graduate or college or whatever. Like let's keep it at current reading level just for now, just for the heck of it. Down here, you can adjust the length, but again, you can toggle it. Why do I get so excited about this? Because this is a better user interface, and user interfaces is what's going to change behavior and get people actually adopting generative AI. And then even down here, suggest edits. Now, this can be very powerful because a lot of times you want to say, hey, you want to make it better, but you don't know how. Now, there's a little hack with ChatGPT where you just say, make this better. And it will, because it'll keep on refining its own work. But if we just hit suggest edits, let's see if it works. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. It's in beta right now. Okay, look, that's what it already did. I made the text more dramatic. So now it's highlighting, like I attempted to blah, 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 simplifying. Unfortunately, an error occurred. Okay, so that's okay. The error occurred, not the end of the world. But I'll tell you, like in this example, it didn't work. But what this usually does is when you go in here and you hit suggest edits and other things like that, it's going to be like, hey, okay, you know what? I tightened this up. And before you had this and and maybe we can make it better like this. It's editing its own writing as if it's a different person, a better writer coming in. That's what's so amazing about Canva. Get a paid subscription to this because you can actually now really create sort of like new things inline. You can create a big blog or whatever, but you can change specific parts of the writing. Guys, it doesn't sound like, oh, video generation, but this is how people use ChatGPT. This is what's going to help drive behavior. I'm super excited about this. Okay, so that's Canvas on ChatGPT. Guys, I'm telling you, this is huge. Why? Because this is how we change behavior. This is how we drive adoption. Again, it's not as fancy or as crazy as some of the other cool tech demos, but who cares if people aren't using it? Who's using video generation? Like nobody, right? It's just something to play around with. Canvas is something you're actually going to use because, again, 99% of what we do on ChatGPT is just writing stuff. Try it out. Play with it. The best part is that it's a really clean user interface, and that will change everything. That's what I'm excited about. Let's try it out.